much for both the panels, including myself,
to provide very interesting remarks. And I believe there are a lot of similarities between the Philippines and India. And a lot of initiatives are there that, you know, both the countries can pick upon and learn from each other. And I actually believe that, you know, the report that will come out of this project would benefit both the countries as well as Vietnam, since it could be a comparative study or a report that would provide the actual scenario, ground-based scenario that digital economy has in all the three countries. So again, it was a very interesting experience to learn about the fintech e-health initiatives that country is having. And then again, when we talk about digital economy, data again is a very big part of it, as we call it. So in a recent discussion and an article, Mr. Nandan Nilkeni, who was the spearhead, who was spearheading the Aadhaar card, the unique ID initiative in India, he said data is the new oil. So, you know, considering his words and quoting and unquoting that, it actually is true in this particular sense. Because when we see, and when WhatsApp was purchased by Facebook for, I guess, for 20 something billion rupees, right? And it was just a platform. What it had was data. That's it. So a huge amount of data sold for a huge, huge amount of money. Considering digital innovations in both the countries, and obviously there are regulatory barriers and bottlenecks that, you know, both the countries may face, but it was glad to know that, you know, fintech is being loved by the regulatory body, and they love the regulatory body as well. There are not many companies that can claim that they are being loved and, you know, returning the love in the same sense. So it's a win-win for both consumers and service providers. One thing that government has to realize that, you know, a government cannot work in silos and to provide all the services to the consumers. Private organizations, though they work for profit, but they also provide some very important services to the consumers. So regulation should always follow optimal point, so that it does not fall on either too much regulation or too light regulation. Light touch regulation would probably be the best word. And as was said, affordable and adaptable e-payment systems need to be provided to the consumers, so that, you know, as the internet penetration and the service penetration goes, people should be interested in doing those services, because they are getting better benefits out of them. And the project has already been discussed by Dr. Lanto, so I would not go into that. Thank you very much, everyone, for coming and joining us here. And this is the official launch of the Philippines Regional Inclusive Growth Project, also known as Diginomics 1. And I thank you, everyone, for coming and sharing your insights and questions with us. Thank you.